Don here. Well, I'm going to work on my carburetor on my 76 Blazer. I'm going to replace the fuel transfer tube. So I put this camera up here under the hood where I could make sure it's not going to fall. It's hanging on the coat hang wire and a little thing that holds cameras. Here comes a truck. Oh, the tree trimming truck.
Okay.
Well, first off, I'll get over there and work on the phone. First time I've tried this little setup with this. First time I've tried the coat hanger to hold the camera. It's pretty low. It doesn't have a real voltmeter, but it gives you an idea. Let's see. I have to watch that my timer's not, doesn't work. It just tells you how long you've been going there. Okay, well, I just have to keep checking on it. The timer doesn't go off anymore. I just keep running no matter where it's at. But it charges the screen. Now, I know I'm going to need a few tools. I might get by with my quarter inch set, but I may have to get. I might have to get my 3/8. This one's unplugged. Oh, there's a battery indicator on there. It's still good. Everything's so tiny I can't hardly see it anyway, though, doesn't it? Work. bulb maybe is bad. My bulb is not working since just the other day. I brought it in the house and used it for an extension cord. It has plugs on the side. This is really old. This is only the other line. Actually, this part's newer. It's from the like the 80s or 70s or whatever. And this other part, I don't know how old it is. It was around the house ever since I was a kid. And I put it had a metal one, and every time you bumped it, it would break the light. Yeah, it's broke. These work pretty good. They don't get as hot. But I don't know why it got broke. It's broke down loose at the base. I do need a little lighter. I have another light bulb over here. That's not good either. I found another shorter one, but it's shorter. It's probably like 40 watt. The other one's break on this too, so. I'll give away, so if it is on, it won't blind me. I don't know which one's which. What's wrong with you? You know, that light might have still worked. I don't have the switch turned on. I use that to turn my air compressor on and off. It always works better when you turn the power strip switch on. Everything works better that way. Okay. Get a couple of in wrenches because I don't want to need a couple. I think I have an idea. I'm just going to get my whole little thing because I'll try to get up there and stay up there. Get a couple of good rags. At least some of what I'll need. We'll find out when we get up there what I'm missing. I like these holders, but they don't hold. I shouldn't even have started this other camera. I don't seem to have this in the best spot. Something's wrong here. I thought I remembered how I always did it with this ladder. I used to do the big ladder. I used to crawl up the front of it. that's even worse. Maybe I was doing it like this. Yeah, I guess so. I don't want my thing of tools falling off. I'll watch out when I'm crawling up and down the ladder. I'll kick it off of here. I've done it before. Can't remember how I do everything. I put some gloves on because it's so grimy up there. I know I won't be able to work with tools very well. I'll take them off when I get to that point. I think this is it. Okay, yeah, I'm finally here. See if it's recording. Well, one thing, I'll keep hitting my head. Yeah, it's still recording. Let me get it plugged in so it won't run down. This is the one with the smaller SD card though, so I tried to start it right when I needed it, and not too early, but I didn't do it right. Also, I'm having trouble getting it plugged in. It'll shut my thing down, or if I cover up my, let's leave it there, it'll stop moving at some point. Oh, it's about to come out of it. It's a little, this is my first try with using, I just made this out of some parts, we'll say. Yeah. Coat hanger, if you got a coat hanger and if you got coat hangers and duct tape, you can do anything. You can get by with masking tape sometimes, but okay, yeah, it's gonna just keep moving, isn't it? Okay, so see when I move around in the truck, but I can't help it.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, this thing is really dirty. It hasn't been cleaned or anything in 2 years. Okay, so. It's sitting here waiting for me to give it some attention. Alright, let's see. Yeah, see, every time I jump around in the truck, I think it'll at least be, it's a good, better than the one way back yonder, better shot. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and put this, no, that won't stay. I often put it way over here. No, I don't have room anymore. Oh, I think I used to do that. Yeah. Just as long as it won't fall, I'm happy. Okay, so carburetor. I'm seeing if it was even in the shop right now. Yeah, carburetor. I can't start it because the battery ran down. So I'm charging it while I'm doing this. I don't remember where I always sit. You can actually shut the hood in here if you really wanted to, with you in it. Well, not really. I mean, you wouldn't like it on this side. You could, not the side with the battery. Anyway, there's a tube right here called the fuel transfer tube, and it is leaking like a sieve. And I believe it was leaking for at least 3 years, and I could not ever catch it. Finally, it dawned on me. I thought about it, but it, I never saw it leaking. I didn't remember what it was called, but I bought this carburetor when I bought the truck in about 90 to 92. I can't even remember now. I think it was 92. Brand new, the carburetor was brand new. And anyway, I was watching those Roadkill Hot Rod Magazine shows online, and they had that problem with one, and they explained it. So that finally made me go, oh, let's check that on mine. Still didn't see it. Finally, the leak started leaking bad enough that I could find it. I think it was probably a few, several months later after the first time I even thought about that. fuel's all ran back down, but that's to be expected. What I'm trying to decide is, do I want to just take the carburetor off, or do I want to just try to take the bowl, front bowl? I think I'm going to try the front bowl. They said, you know, I mean, obviously you can do it either way, but there's a lot more on the carburetor than I remember. I used to take carburetor off in 10 minutes easy, but I'm not that fast anymore. I can't even hardly get up and down in here anymore. So, I think I'll get up here. I don't need these tools in my way, but I might need them. Okay. And I believe I do have my little quarter inch socket, so it'll work good for that. I think I will take the fuel line off just to get it out of the way. I usually slide my clamps on back, well, on each, to get them out of the way. Makes it easier to get the hose off without damaging it too, if you do that. It may be old enough to be replaced already. Can't reach my tools. But I'll turn it that way. Just try not to kick it when I'm going up and down, or I will have it off on the ground. Yeah, this is prone to leak because it's a swivel. And that, now that I've moved it, I'll probably need to put, it doesn't provide a place to put a gasket or anything, but I put some former gasket red on it. Well, that's good. I might just go ahead and put a new piece of paper on that. I don't have any calluses or anything, so my hands are tender. I haven't been working a long time on stuff, so might have to cut it. Oh, wow. I didn't remember it being that hard to get on there. But how would I know? It's been so long. I didn't bring my little knife with me. I do have my pocket knife, though. I'll try one more time to get it off, and then I'll just cut it. I need one of those pries on it a little bit. There. If it's in good shape, I'll keep it. If it's not, I won't. Put that back to there. Just don't forget to put it on there when you're done. Okay. Let's see. It's getting hot up in here now, the sun. Well, the sun is actually up high enough that the shade tree, I'm a shade tree mechanic. I got a nice big shade tree. But the sun is up high enough now to get me some shade, a little bit. But it's still hot. A vacuum line for my what? Where's that go? Oh, that goes up into the cab of the truck. I had had trouble. What I didn't realize, I didn't know what was wrong. The hoses on the gas tank had cracked, and they were leaking down, and all the of course, this has been a long time, and that's expected, but just in a few days it would leak down and there wouldn't be any gas in the filter there. That's those glass viewable filters. And it wouldn't want to start, and I would spray either, you know, starting fluid. I ran that vacuum line all the way up into the cab of the truck so I could spray starting fluid into the manifold from the truck. Or WD-40 will work. Burns too. Yeah, I think if I take this front one off, I can slide it forward and then get that replaced. Hopefully. I don't think I'm going to stay sitting on my legs like that for any longer, though. Let's see. Find the right socket. Yeah, this little, I got the quarter inch socket set. I think it'll be just right for this. But I could actually use a little breeze right now. There's a tiny breeze going on right here. Let's see. I'm going to move those because I think I'm just going to end up knocking them down. Let's see. Well, that's going to be a shaky video. Wish I had the other camera up here because it's loose. Because it, I don't know what the deal is. Three identical phones, the same open camera app. One of them still, there's a feature I like to use, you know, stabilize, image stabilization. One of them, it's working on. The other two, it's disappeared. I can't find it. Let's see, what size, I can't see them on. Let's see what size it is. I'm going to put one on a nut driver. They're very loose. Probably the ones in the back probably need tightening up too. So it's time to take them off. Whether I may have, no, there's car fuel in there. I may have the it was like varnish too. It's been sitting so long. I had some stuff I bought for old gas treatment that actually seemed to help to put in this thing, and I've used it all up, I think. Probably should get some more. It's been a long time since I did rebuild this carburetor, so I did know it inside and out, but now it's been so long, I really don't remember what all it takes to get this bowl off. But I may need a gas. If I don't run the gasket, I'll put some former gasket on it. It should be alright. If I do, then I will need, I might have one in my carburetor, that old carburetor kit, an extra one that would work. There's a little spot there that you can, still doesn't seem like it wants to come loose, and I don't want to hurt the gasket. Ah, there we go, just a little more persuasion, but not too much. I don't know which side I should take it off from, I think I should leave it on the carburetor. Should have got me a putty knife ahead of time. Aha! Float's moving. Let's see. Yeah, I'm out of the picture now. I gotta stay over here by the carburetor. Accelerator pump. It's a different looking one. I'm used to the Carter AFBs. That's what I grew up on from my 70s. Chevy's, I had a 76 Chevelle. I used to work on that thing all the time. Had a Carter AFB 4 barrel. It was actually a good carburetor once you got it working right. Okay, so you know that was amazingly easy. Oh look, okay, this one, and I had to buy a new tube, transfer tube anyway, because I don't know where to set it. Set it up in my toolbox. This is not near as bent as I thought it was. Let's put it up. See if I can see what I'm showing here. Where is it? Yeah, it doesn't really look too bent, but there's no seal on that end. There may be some seal left up inside of the deal. I'll look. But this seal's on here. But, yeah, I thought it was bent real bad. It's not bent at all, but it's designed different. I'll get the other one. I didn't bring it over here. I kept thinking I should bring it over here, and I thought, oh no, I don't need it yet. See, I wouldn't have to get out. But yeah, this has O-rings. I might have been able to use this one and just put some new O-rings on it if I could find, you know, get some that can handle gasoline. But as long as that new one I bought fits, they say it works better. That's the thing, I wanted to replace it with the one they say works better. I wrote to Holley, ordered it from Holley. So that's what I decided. I did a bunch of checking first. I got gas on my hands now anyway, so let's go ahead and look at that fit. Yeah, I didn't put any gasket sealer on this the first time, so it didn't get ruined just now. The bits. So yeah, it's in pretty good shape, but I do believe I want to put some seal on it this time. I'm gonna have to get it in the light where I can really look at it, but I got just enough light to kind of see what I'm doing. But it looks okay, it's not broken, so I'm gonna go ahead and use it. I mean, I can look at the others. Got a couple of divots in it there, but I think as long as I put some sealer on it, it'll be alright. look at the, yeah, that little, I think that's the rest of, yeah, that's the rest, that's the actual accelerator pump. The other part was the actuator for it. I'm going to go get my magnifying glass with the light on it, and that'll help me look things over. If there's any crap clogged up in those jets, this is the time to clean them out. And the back, I can could do the back, too, you know. But it's been running fine when I start it, so I'm not going to go nuts for no reason. But I do believe I need to buy me some of that old gas treatment. That really does seem to do some help, some good. There's my vacuum one. It's actually a fairly new one. How are the others? Yeah, they're okay. But dang, anything that the fuel touches, that dadgum alcoholic, ethanol alcohol they put in the fuel, it ruins all the... I was saying that's what ruined my... I had this truck since 90, just say 90. I think it was 92. I'm crazy, I know. Never had, I had to, in the last 10 years, I've had to replace this, these gas lines on the gas tank and the ones in the front twice. Never had to do that before, and they were old when I got it, you know. Now, up in here, with the heat, yeah, these will get old. But the ones on the gas tank, they lasted, well, the first time I did it, they looked like factory hoses. And I had to do it again about a year or two, 2 years ago, or 3 years, probably 3 years ago now. I was telling that story about it leaking down, you know, no fuel in the filter. And that's pretty hard to reach and get to. You can do it. Luckily, this is a 4x4 and it's up high. It's actually lifted about 4 inches. So I could do it without even jacking it up, but it sure was hard to reach up there and do it. Better than a lot of these where you got to take the tank out or something. Okay, I got to go get... That is a bad smell. That's worse than normal gasoline by far. That's old gas. Smells like old boat I used to have that old... Somebody gave me an old boat and it had the oldest gasoline in those tanks. That had been mixed with two-cycle oil. That's what it smells like. Alright, let me go get, what do I want? Well, I'm gonna need the gasket sealer. I need my new tube. And I need, I need to be able to get out of here without falling. I'm so stiff I can't crawl in and out of here. I used to get jumping in and out of here. This is what happens when you get old, kids. Don't get old. Don't get old. All right, now. Get my magnet. I'll just over here. This way. Yeah, gotta have a drink first. Put this over here in the toolbox so I'll have it. I said I was going to get a drink before I'm going to get the stuff out. Okay. Got some more tools in case something I'll probably need. High temp RTV. I want the one that's good for... gasoline. Well, I think I don't think I ever buy any that's going to be good for gasoline. Silicone gasket maker. I think it's just, one's Parmatex and one's another one. Oxygen sensor is safe. Yeah, I think this is one I didn't buy because I have one. Both seem like they're in good shape. Another one comes out a little easier. I think I'll go over it. Cap is stripped on this one. It doesn't know how to be tripped. Okay, so I use that one. And where's mine? This over here is a lot. Okay. Yeah, it's alright. Got a little skin in the scrape line. I may have another one. Let's see. I'll show my tubes. I already showed the old one over here. In the other one. This would be perfect if I was good at getting out of the editing stuff. Oh, I don't have any. I got some interior work. Quite good. Oh wait, there's some new ones down there. Ah, that's what I got. That would not work right. That's probably for the back or some other. It's for another model. Of course, you could cut. If you had to cut out the center, all that other extra parts. I don't think it even matches. Actually, it does match. It might work in a pinch. But yeah. It's pretty much the same thing. It's the same hole, same everything. Oh, wait. Not exact. So, no, it didn't really work. I would rather just use the old one and clean it up. I mean, put a little seal on it. But, yeah, I don't throw away parts, especially new parts. I usually keep, like, if I replace something on my truck, or when I build cars, I would keep, if that place, I've tried to replace things before they were completely worn out, and then I would put the old one in there for emergencies, and I've had to use it before, especially for fan blades. So, these are extra seals. I didn't know for sure if it came with seals, but it did. And I think I forgot to ask him. I didn't want to. I think I wrote them and took them off. Several days around this. So this is a new one, and it's got seals with it. I'm going to pick it up while I get up there, because I'm going to show it up on the other camera, because I probably want to look in the video, but I'm going to look in the inception video. So here's the bowl. Let's see, it's floating and still moving. Accelerator gasket, that's the actuator for it. That's still working on the car. Accelerator get a pump is still in the coverage. So I'm just gonna take it all here. Don't really even need to do any room. I have to clean it with my fingers. There's just a couple of little places that had kind of stuck the peel. The tiniest little bit, a couple thousandths off of it. Got me some putty knives in case I want to do any cleaning or anything. I did want to kind of. Yeah, I'm not going to. Yeah, there's a little bit of that gasket on there. Should move the camera, I guess. Well, I'm showing it, but I'm scraping a little bit of gasket off the bowl. It takes so long to re-aim them, but it just makes things ridiculous. I have to take my air blower and blow it out a little bit. Blow the hole. Whoops, I broke through the holes a little bit. Still recording up there. I'll try to be nice and at least take out all the dead spots out of this video. Once I get it on YouTube, I can take those out real easy. Well, nothing's real easy with that editor. But, I do have some starting fluid and map sensor cleaner. Thought I might have some carburetor cleaner. That's it. So maybe the map sensor will clean my bowl a little bit here. I'll clean that too. Actually, I think I'll do that first. Well, it doesn't matter. It's going to blow the bowl out, but it's... Where's that little hole? There. There's not a bunch of any gum in there. There's not any nasty looking stuff that I was afraid of seeing in there. So that's a good, very good thing. Let me get my, I keep getting this junk on my hands. It's gonna eat them alive. Alright, let's get my light down here. See what we do. I didn't need these big tools. Should have put them away when I was, as long as I don't knock them off, it's alright. Let's see. Throw a few dots in the cooler gasket in there. The jets. I wanted to spray the jets. I think I already go through. Can I see in there? Oh. Chokes them all in. See, look, I can hear it, so it's going through. I think I was really just spraying. I was really just spraying some air out of the can in there, but that's all right. That didn't jump. Let's see. Not a lot of working space up here. I guess there's more than in some vehicles. I can set my cans over there on the other side. Front of the hood there. Okay, now I'm gonna have to line my, oh well, it's got little tabs to hold it, so that should be good. Get my light back. I want to make sure there's not any junk in the, I think I'm gonna get all came out. Yeah, I don't know if there's anything on the, should have scraped first and then sprayed. Yeah, there's not really anything on there. You really want to know feel of it. Yeah, that's alright. I might hit it one more time with the deal, but everything moves. The jets weren't clogged up. Definitely wouldn't want to have it apart and then not fix them. You need to fix it, would you? Okay, where's my spray? Yeah, it's almost empty. That's got it. Don't think I'm going to take the back one off. Matter of fact, before I start doing the front, I'm going to tighten up the back before I start putting my new deal in there. Oh yeah, I got to check for that gasket that's missing. I need something small. I didn't get a small screwdriver. Alright. Oh, ever faithful pocket knife. Where's that light? I didn't have that. look and see if there's anything there to dig out. Yeah, let's fall holding a knife open up. Let's put it down. Okay. I do have on safety glasses, but that's the only thing you're kind of trying to tell, isn't it? Can't see all the way in there. Okay. Yeah, I think so. No, yes, no. I really can't tell for sure if there's one in there or not. Don't feel anything. Might be something right there. I don't want to break my knife. My kids gave me this when they were little kids. And it got, the end got broke once, and I went to a knife shop and got somebody to resharpen it. It was only a little cheap knife. I'm not going to mess with it with the knife anymore. It's actually a well-made knife, but I think they got it at Kmart. Well, they did, back when we had a Kmart. Okay, so that was back in the 80s, or late, or very early 90s, I can't remember now. Got it for my birthday. Okay, so, everything's kind of getting in my way. I'm going to have to go get me a small screwdriver to feel around a little more in there. No matter what I do, I can't see in there. Okay, gotta get down again. Because I don't have one with me. Okay, I got the tools I need now. Take this thing down. I'm not using those tools. Okay. And I'm just worried of knocking it over the whole time here. Okay, figure out how to swing my leg. Now. Okay. This might be, I'm gonna look in the bowl and see. Oh, okay. Well, that still hard to tell when you can't see it. If there's something in there. Think there's, let me look and see if it fell out and I didn't notice it. And it's just laying around in here. Don't see any pieces of anything down there, but I can't see super good. Okay, that's hard. Definitely don't want that in there. Clog things up. I guess I could take this other bowl off. Hate to, but I guess it wouldn't be that hard to get to. Now then I have to deal with that gasket again. Don't think it's in there. But you would think that at least pieces of it would be in there. But it was leaking like a sieve, so maybe it's been, well, 2 years since I discovered the problem. And I was ill, I was sick, and I couldn't do anything for 2 years. So, you know, it might have been coming out and I pulled it off and don't remember it. There's nothing in there that I can tell. It would be really tricky to work with that gasket and get it off and back on there. That's the only reason why I'm hesitating to just take that bowl off. Because getting the bowl off loose would be easy. Yeah, that one's longer and I can twist it. There's nothing in there. So I'm working by feel. Okay, I feel reasonably safe now that there isn't any left behind O-ring in there. And whatever dirt I might have stirred up, I'll spray that cleaner in there. Yeah. Okay. Because I don't see much sense in taking it off. Because that would be the one where I couldn't. Okay, that would be the one where I couldn't get the gasket on and off hardly at all. It'd be really hard. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure these are snugged up here. They're a different size? Oh! There's a regular slide screw. One had come loose. I remember that now. These things are always prone to coming loose. Not the kind of thing you would expect on a carburetor. Yeah, they were just a little loose. Well, I've got a screwdriver right down here. Where is it? If it's not too long. I think it's the only one that's tight. I think it might have it's got a lock washer on it. Yeah, those other ones that have a machine edge on them and doesn't stay. The vibration takes and comes. Of course, then you don't remember ever having the, you know, the carburetor leaking. But, let's see. Yeah, I already showed the old one, so but I'll show the differences in them here. Where's the new one? Here it is. Okay, let me get it up here. If I set up here, I can show better, show and tell better. And I can, guess I'll get my knife to open that with. Oh, here we go. I've got a utility knife with me now. It's dull as I'll get out, but it worked. I'm going to move some of these tools so that I'll be able to get to my nuts. My bolts, my nuts. Bolts. Okay, so this one, I don't want to drop it trying to show it to the camera. I'll leave it in there. But you can see the little black things are the seals in the bag. Just need to make sure they go, get them in there the right way. I'll have to look at that. And this one has a flared end on it there. And an O-ring. It'll stop, you know, like a seal point for the O-ring. Of course, the other one's missing altogether. But yeah, I probably could have just found some gas-resistant O-rings and just replaced them. But since it probably leaked for years and years and I couldn't figure it out, I'm mad at it. I want it out of there. And they did say this is a better design, so hopefully it is. It has rubber seals that slide over the end. I think it's probably a little shorter. But they don't want to come out of that bag. Take them out one at a time. I'm not showing what I'm doing, but I can't do that too well right now. I can't stay squatted down in there for very long. And then trying to hold it up over the carburetor where you can see it. Just, yeah, okay, here we go. I can see there's really only one way they're going to want to go around there. Oh, yeah. I remember that from the pictures now. Online. Slowly it comes back. Okay. Slowly it comes back. Let's see. Try shorter. Okay, so you slide it over the end. And then it's all rubber there. Where is it? Come on, come on. There we go. So they put them on like that as opposed to, you know, an O-ring and a rised end on it. So we'll see how well that works. And I had thought there might be a problem with that too being smaller in diameter than the old one, but it's not. You can see right there, they're the same diameter. There's how their design is different. So I'm gonna put the old one in that bag. That's still a save. That's a saver. If I find me some O-rings that size, even if they weren't the gas-resistant kind, that actually most of it would resist gas for a pretty good while, I think. The ones that were good for plumbing would last a pretty good while. But I'd rather have something that say resist gas. I mean, why would you want to put something else on your carburetor? I mean, this could have even caused a fire. It got so bad. Okay, now first though, before I get too happy and fast on all this, I gotta put this